Okay, so I guess good evening, everybody. My name is Dr. Geoff Steeves. I'm a physics professor at the University of Victoria on the west coast of Canada, and so it's almost 11 a.m. for me, so I've still got my morning coffee. Anyway, I'm really glad to be able to speak with you today, and I hope you find this talk interesting. Before I get started, I just want to say a little bit more about my background. So I'm a physics professor at the University of Victoria, but I'm also a professor at the International Space University. And this is a very interesting organization that I got involved with back in 2010, and I continue to be involved with the International Space University. What I'm going to speak with you about today is some of my experiences when I applied to be an astronaut. So a few years ago, the Canadian Space Agency offered an opportunity to become an astronaut, and I went through just about the entire process. So what I want to share with you today is my experiences competing to become an astronaut. So the talk is going to be basically a guide on the 2008-2009 astronaut recruitment campaign in Canada. And these are things to keep in mind for all astronaut recruitment campaigns, whether you're looking to compete in, you know, and become an American astronaut, or I know ESA had a campaign. Actually, there was an ESA campaign going on at the same time that I was competing. So I'll try to just share the experience with you, and then you can ask questions at the end. So having survived both rounds of aptitude testing, I was lucky enough to be invited to Toronto for the next phase, and this was going to be a press announcement where they announced the 16 finalists in the recruitment campaign to the country of Canada, and this was also combined with medical testing as well. So at this point, you know, you've probably dreamed of becoming an astronaut all your life, as had I. When there are 16 of you competing for two spots to become an astronaut, things really start feeling real, and you start to actually hope that you may be successful in your quest. We were flown to Toronto this time, in kind of in the center of Canada, for a series of medical exams, additional psychological exams. We met with psychiatrists from NASA and the Canadian Space Agency, as well as that press announcement. We were marched out on stage in front of several reporters from Canadian news stations and presented as the 16 finalists in the astronaut recruitment campaign, and that's me in the center there with a blue shirt on, just to the left of Steve McLean, who's the president of the Canadian Space Agency at the time. Even though we look like we're all happy and smiling, right before this happened, we had blood samples taken from us. Each one of us had about 20 vials of blood removed from our bodies, so we were all a little bit lightheaded. And as you see on the bottom right, several of us were also wearing Holter monitors, and this is a device where a number of electrodes are connected to your body to monitor your heart rate. So I'm actually wearing one of these Holter monitors during the press announcement. They're monitoring my vital statistics and my heart rate. Right after the announcement and right after we stood on stage like this, they played a video of our experiences, and I'd like to show you that video right now. So this will take you through some of our experiences.
Piloting a ship facing forward.
Yes, without any rotations.
Here, how much it's going to have to move. I'm just going to do it.
Green crosses.
That's okay.
Okay. I'll just go back to the presentation here. That was the video that we saw, and we had actually never seen it ourselves. And right after that video was played, we began to meet with reporters who were there to discuss the recruitment campaign. So it was a very, very exciting and interesting time for us. I really like the video because the last person that you see is me about to jump off that platform. And that was a timed event where we had to jump off that platform and then swim and pull ourselves onto a life raft. It was very interesting to observe that, and then, you know, exciting to be able to share with reporters from the media our experiences, because it's a very exciting process and people are genuinely interested. It's a very positive story. So it was a It was great fun. When you get a little bit of fame or celebrity or there's a big announcement like this, you start searching for yourself on the internet, and I came across this page, you know, and you know, I wasn't able to read what it said, but I thought it was kind of amusing that you can start to see articles about yourself in other languages even. So quite interesting, and this was a newspaper in Canada that you know, presented us. And when we were doing medical testing in some of the hospitals later that week, the staff in the hospitals were asking for our signatures, and this is one of the pages I just took a picture of. So it was kind of fun to be famous for a brief period of time, a little bit famous. The rest of the week was quite challenging. I mean, I'm somebody who likes to take tests, you know. I've been in academia a long time. I enjoy studying and so on. But when it comes to medical testing, it's a difficult thing because really they are just evaluating, you know, your body, your health, and so on. And there's really not anything that you can do about the results that they're going to find. So this is very stressful. I don't know the details of our recruitment campaign, but this is particularly stressful for military pilots because they do very, very exhaustive medical testing on us, much more exhaustive than you would ever have, you know, just as a normal person, because it's very costly. So they did full body MRI scans, CT scans, ultrasound, Doppler ultrasound on our heart. They spent hours studying our eyes, doing optical computed tomography on our eyes. Just a huge array of tests. And I know in U.S. astronaut recruitment campaigns, there have been pilots who have had all this testing done where they'll discover something wrong with you which could potentially end your flying career. You have to be incredibly committed to even go through this testing because the results of this testing could not only disqualify you from being an astronaut, but they could actually affect your ability to do your job as a pilot, for instance. From the medical testing phase, there was just one more final interview step. And then they selected two candidates to become astronauts. And so the way that they describe these tests, from the time that we initially applied up to the final 16, what they did was they selected people out, basically. They pulled people out of the running who didn't have the right qualifications, who weren't able to pass the tests and so on. For the final selection, what they considered was select-in criteria. And so after the final interview, they looked at the final group, and they, at this point, they tried to make a decision as to who would be best to serve as an astronaut for Canada with the type of missions that we foresee in the future and the requirements of our space agency. So they selected two individuals. Unfortunately, this is where my part of the competition ended. I wasn't selected. But they selected two incredible individuals, David Saint-Jacques on the far left. He has a PhD in astrophysics from Cambridge. After his PhD, he did some research in Japan, and then he actually went back to school again and became a medical doctor and was practicing rural medicine in rural Canada in the Canadian Arctic when he was selected. Jeremy Hansen is in the middle there, and he is from the military side, so he has a master's degree in physics, and he was an F-18 pilot when he was selected. So the day that they were selected, their lives changed. In the upper right-hand corner of the screen, you see them meeting with Canada's Prime Minister. On the right-hand, in the middle, and the bottom, there are a couple images of David trying to give Jeremy some training in reviving or resuscitating a simulated patient. And on the bottom right, Jeremy was giving David flying lessons. So they're amazing individuals, and they continue to be very successful astronauts for Canada, and I've been lucky enough to stay in touch with them. My story kind of takes a detour at this point, so In my case, my experience was what it was like to be rejected. And it's a tough experience. And you think about it, 5,351 people applied. 5,349 of those people who were qualified were essentially rejected. So what do all of us folks do? To answer that question, I came back to one of the questions I experienced during the interview. What would you do if you even were an astronaut but weren't selected for a mission? And I was able to talk to a lot of astronauts through the selection process. There were astronauts interviewing us at different stages and so on. And we talked a lot about what astronauts do career-wise when they're not up in space. They spend a tiny, tiny fraction of their lives actually up in space on missions. And through the campaign, I got a lot of information as to what they do when they're not on missions. In terms of continuing their training, in terms of continuing to be scientists or engineers or doctors, in terms of doing public outreach. And it led me to think, well, how much of that stuff that astronauts normally do could I be doing right now? And the answer was an awful lot of it. When I was in the Dunker competing right after that event, I met with other candidates, and one of the things I discovered was this organization called the International Space University. And out of the top 39 finalists, 9 of them had attended the International Space University. So since I wasn't selected as an astronaut, I decided to attend. I attended as a student in 2010. And ever since then, I've continued to be involved in the International Space University. And most recently, I was involved in SSP 14 in Montreal. So that's one of the things that, by going to the International Space University, it actually gave me a much broader perspective on what the space industry is all about and how I could be involved. And since then, I've stayed involved by teaching at the Space University, but also getting involved in outreach. I have a comic book that I developed with an artist in Toronto called Star Racer Academy, and these are comics for young students who want to become astronauts. So if you have friends or family members who are kind of in grades 4 to 6, be sure to send them to starraceracademy.com where they can read some of our comics. Finally, just looking back on the experience, I would say if you ever have a chance to apply to become an astronaut, I would encourage you to do it. Enjoy the ride for as long as it lasts, and maybe you'll be lucky enough to be selected. But even if you aren't selected, you can use the experience to change your life. Be sure to stay in touch with the amazing people that you'll meet along the way. And this has been very, very positive in my life, is just staying in touch with the other astronauts, the other candidates that you meet, because they're all pretty remarkable people, the ones who are selected but also the ones who aren't. And if you are able to do this, you may have some amazing opportunities. I've had some great opportunities to be involved in the Canadian Space Program. I've been able to meet all of our astronauts and even socialize with some of them, which has been really amazing. By doing things like this, you continue to develop opportunities for yourself in space, and you never know what that'll lead to. From my point of view, I was very lucky through this experience to get an incredible personal memento, which is a picture that Bob Thirsk, a Canadian astronaut, took for me when he was on the International Space Station. He printed off the top 16 finalists with our pictures and biographies, and he took a picture with himself and each one of us at the window of the International Space Station. So this has been an incredible experience for me, and I hope it's helped you get a better understanding of what it's like to compete to be an astronaut. And I hope all of you will consider doing this in the future. Thank you.